Hello, class. This is Madam Rachel from Musana Vocation High School. Today we are going to talk about carbon and its compounds, a topic that lies according to our syllabus in Senior 3. So with carbon and its compounds, there is a lot that we are going to talk about in this topic, but for the introductory part of it, we shall talk about the occurrence of carbon as our first subtopic. We shall talk about the allotropes of carbon. Under the allotropes of carbon, here we have graphite, we have diamond, we have amorphous carbon. And then we shall also talk about the chemical reaction of carbon. Under the chemical reaction of carbon, here we have reaction with oxygen. Carbon reacts with oxygen, we are all aware about it. Here getting carbon dioxide in excess oxygen and getting carbon monoxide in little supply of oxygen. Then have another reaction that is with the steam. Remember, this carbon also reacts with the steam. Here we get carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. We also have carbon reacting with metal oxides. Remember here, and we get the, when carbon reacts with the metal oxide, you will find that here we get the carbon displacing the oxygen from the metal oxide. Here getting the carbon dioxide and the metal alone. Then under the reaction, chemical reaction of carbon, we still have reaction of carbon with acids. And not all acids here react with carbon, but mainly we look at nitric acid and sulfuric acid. So getting back to the introductory part of it, we are beginning with occurrence of carbon. What do we mean by saying occurrence of carbon? With occurrence of carbon, we want to know how much or how carbon, in which form does carbon exist? But before we should get to the occurrence of carbon, let us understand the meaning of this word carbon. According to our senior 1, senior 2 chemistry, we learnt about elements, and here we are much aware that carbon is an element. And being that carbon is an element, that means it has an atomic number. So we can use this atomic number to get its electronic configuration that can enable us to get its group and its period. And being that carbon has an atomic number, of 6, so that means when we are writing its electronic configuration of carbon, we have to use this atomic number. And if the electronic configuration of carbon, it is electronic configuration, it is 2 to 4. This means that the first energy level is taking a maximum of 2, and being that the total is 6, then it has a remainder of 4. So this 4 goes to the next energy level. So this is the electronic configuration of carbon, which is 2 to 4. So this means, being that we have known the atomic number, the atomic number is leading us to electronic configuration, so we can use this electronic configuration to determine the group and the period of this element called carbon. So looking at the electronic configuration, we can conclude by saying that carbon belongs to group 4. Carbon belongs to group 4. Yeah, here we use the Roman numerals when writing the group of a particular element. So carbon belongs to group 4. The 4, it is just the number of electrons in its outermost shell or energy level. So carbon belongs to group 4, and then it also belongs to period 2. Where is the 2 coming from? And remember, we are using Roman numerals to represent. You are not allowed to write period using a figure. Now, group using a figure, this is wrong. So you can easily represent them this way, that it belongs to period 2 and then group 4. I've explained where the 4 is coming from, that the last energy level, the number of electrons it contains, that gives it the group of a particular element. And then that period, we count the number of shells that have been occupied by the total number or by the atomic number, and that gives us the period. When you count that this is the first energy level, this is 1, and this is the second energy level, this is 2, that is why we are saying that it belongs to period 2. When you're looking at a topic called periodic table, then this gives it out so much clearly. So simply, we have known what carbon is. It is an element having atomic number 6, atomic configuration list, and then belonging to group 4, and then belonging to period 2.
So getting to exocarbons, how does it exist? We are going to realize that this carbon exists in two forms or two states. You can either find it in its free state, can either find it in its free state, or you can find it in its combined state. In its combined state, this is where you're going to find carbon existing as carbonates. If we are giving examples of compounds, and then someone find mention something like sodium hydrogen carbonate, meaning it is having the carbon component of it, so it is its combined state. So we have another combined state here. We have the carbonates. Still under the combined state, we have the mineral oils and so on. So mineral oils, carbonates lie under the combined state of carbon. And then we can also find carbon in living organisms, for example in plants and in animals. However, being that we have known that states where carbon belongs, we also have, it also has two forms in which it belongs, backing up this free state and then the combined state. You can still find carbon in its natural form, or you can also find it in its synthetic form. In its natural form, this carbon can be, in its natural form, you find carbon existing as graphite and diamond. This is the natural form of carbon. And you can also find it existing in its synthetic form. Someone can easily ask, what is the meaning of synthetic? Synthetic, it is, we can talk about in relating to making. If it has been tampered with, if your natural making has been tampered with, then someone can easily say you've been synthesized, you've been made up, you've been changed your outlook. So, the synthetic form of carbon, here we have charcoal, here we have carbon fiber, and others. So after knowing the occurrence of carbon, we have known it belongs both in free state and combined state, the combined state carbonates, mineral ions and others, then the forms, we have the natural form, we have mentioned graphite and diamond, that is the natural form of carbon. Then the synthetic form of carbon, I've mentioned something like, we have the carbon fiber, it's a natural form, the charcoal you use at home, that is the synthetic form of it, carbon fiber, synthetic form of it. Then, so we have briefly known how much or how carbon can exist. So there are very many things that you come across in the environment when you realize and study far about them, realize that they comprise of carbon. So after knowing that carbon has all those different forms in which it exists, then that drives us to something we are calling allotropes of carbon. Someone can be to ask, what is the meaning of the word allotropes? Allotropes is coming from the word allotropy. Allotropes is coming from the word allotropy. Remember, when I was talking about the natural form of carbon, I said it may exist as graphite and diamond. So this is bringing us to the insight that we should explain it better, to know why, how can it exist as diamond, and then it is existing as a graphite, yet it is the same thing. So that brings us to this word, allotropy. Allotropy is the existence of an element, in two or more forms in the same physical state. I can pardon that. Allotropy is the existence of an element, in two or more forms in the same physical state. I can really bring an example myself. If I'm calling myself Madame Rachel, when Musana as high school calls me Madame Rachel, then I go to a different school and I call myself, for example, Madame Lydia. When in Musana, I teach chemistry, but when I go to another school, I'm teaching biology. Meaning, I'm the same person in my same physical state. So I'm trying to bring up the meaning of allotropy, existence of an element in two or more forms in the same physical state. So I'm the same Madame Rachel, but when I'm at Musana, I'm behaving as a chemistry teacher. But when I'm going to a different school, I'm behaving as a biology teacher. But I'm the same person. That means I'm the same. same, I'm still in the same physical state, but then I'm having different properties at one point. So we are defining this as the existence of one element. In this particular case, we are talking about carbon. So the existence of this carbon in two or more forms, but in the same physical state. Because in the natural we are saying that carbon can be a graphite or a diamond, but then it is the same carbon. So this existence of an element in two or more forms in the same physical state is what we are calling allotropy. And then one thing you should know about this kind of elements that exist as allotropes, or that have different elements in them that have the same physical properties, that different physical properties but the same chemical property, then you can find that these kind of elements have their properties in a different way that you can need to come up with. What do I mean? Allotropes, they have different crystalline structure. They also have different physical properties. But they have the same chemical properties. So you find that being that examples of allotropes of allotropes of carbon, we have graphite, we have diamond, we have amorphous carbon. Meaning all these ones exist as carbon in two or more forms, but having the same physical state. And I'm saying that allotropes of carbon or allotropes of elements have different crystalline structures and also different physical properties, but they have the same chemical properties. So what do I mean? Same chemical properties. So that means that graphite, diamond, and amorphous carbon, meaning that these are all allotropes of carbon. So that means that all these ones have different physical properties, have different crystalline structure, but they have the same chemical properties. And that makes them belong to the same element we are calling carbon. So we shall be looking at each and every atom of carbon, one by one. We look at its crystalline structure, what is its makeup. We look at its physical properties, which ones are different. And then also look at the uses of this particular. Look at the uses of these particular atoms of carbon. So we shall be beginning with diamond.